Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about solving trig equations, and we're going to work with trig equations that have an interval. So we need to be careful because the interval can either include or exclude certain possible solutions to your equation. So let's take a look at this one here. We have an interval of 0 to 2 pi. So if we were to draw that out on a number line, this being 0, back here being 2 pi, what this is saying is that 0 is included, so that's a closed dot. We know 0 is included because of this square bracket, and then that means all possible solutions leading up to 2 pi, but we see an open parenthesis, which means 2 pi is not included as a solution, so that is shown by an open circle. So now let's take a look at the trig equation that we want to try to solve. So let's go with tangent squared theta sine theta is equal to tangent squared theta. Let's take a quick look at a common mistake in trying to solve an equation such as this. A lot of times you'll see that there's a tangent squared on both sides, so you say, hey, let me go ahead and divide both sides by tangent squared. So dividing both sides by tangent squared, this becomes sine theta is equal to 1. The reason why this is not what you want to do is because when you eliminate that trig function of tangent, you're actually eliminating possible solutions. So we don't want to use this method, or we don't want to take this approach in trying to solve such a problem. We need to try to keep it as intact as possible to make sure we can bring to light all of the possible solutions. So let me go ahead and rewrite tangent squared theta sine theta is equal to tangent squared theta. Better approach is to subtract tangent squared theta from both sides. So I'm left with tangent squared theta sine theta minus tangent squared theta is equal to 0. I just move this tangent squared theta to the left-hand side. Now I see in both of my terms, they share a tangent squared theta. So let's factor out a tangent squared theta. All right, when I factor out a tangent squared theta, that leaves me with a sine theta here. And when I factor out a tangent squared theta from here, this becomes 1. So now I have two factors that are set equal to 0. Because these two factors are being multiplied together, that means if either one of these is 0, my result is going to be 0. And what that allows me to do is to solve each one of these factors for 0 so I can separate this. So now this becomes tangent squared theta equals 0. And sine theta minus 1 equals 0. Now let's work with trying to solve the equation here on the left for theta. So let's go ahead and take the square root of both sides because this tangent is being squared. So I'm left with tangent theta is equal to 0. And now let's work with this other equation, sine theta minus 1 equals 0. Let's add 1 to both sides. So this here becomes sine theta is equal to 1. Now we're going to use properties that we know of the unit circle to figure out what values of theta will make tangent 0 and what values of sine will make this equation 1. So let's quickly just put in the different pieces of the drawing of the unit circle. So that's pi over 2. That there is supposed to be pi. This here is 3 pi over 2, and then we're going to place in the coordinates as though the circle was drawn here. So the coordinates for this, as though the unit circle is drawn here. The coordinates for this point are 1, 0. Coordinates for this point are 0, 1. For this point here, negative 1, 0. For this point down here, negative 1. And we're going to fall back on some of the other things that we know. We know that this is the x-coordinate. That's the y-coordinate. We also know that the x-coordinate corresponds to cosine theta, and the y-coordinates correspond to sine theta. So we're going to use that information to help us solve this problem here. All right, tangent theta can be rewritten as sine theta over cosine theta. Those are equivalent. We also know from basic fractions is that if my numerator is 0, then that means that the whole value for the fraction is zero. So I'm going to look for a sine value of zero because that's going to make this tangent theta a zero. So let's take a look. Here I see at pi, my y value is zero. And at zero and 2 pi, my y value is zero. So what that says is that the values for theta can be zero, pi, and 2 pi, because those would all give me back a result of 0. And now let's look at sine theta. When sine theta is 1, that means we need to try to find the y values that have a 1. And if we look at pi over 2, that's the only place where my y value is 1, so I know here that theta has to be pi over 2 for that to be correct. Now before we settle on these possible solutions, we need to go back and take a look at our interval. We said that our interval goes from 0 to 2 pi, not including 2 pi. So we see 0 is a good answer. It's a good solution here. We see that pi over 2 is a good solution. We see that pi is a good solution. And then when we come to 2 pi, I see that 2 pi is not included on the interval, so I will not use that as a possible solution. So I see that the following three values of theta are my solutions for this particular equation. All right, thank you for watching another video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube page, everything found under the name Speller Tutorial. Thanks again for watching.